not often you see this color of vestment, but we wear it on Gaudete Sunday. The rose is, they say, a mixture of the purple and white. Purple reminding us that Advent is still a time of preparation. White in the sense of joy that the Lord's birth is near. And so it is a day, as St. Paul says, for us to rejoice. Brothers and sisters, how many times do we hear family members or friends, or maybe even our bosses, say to us, "Remember, my door is always wide open." And we appreciate that. We appreciate such graciousness. But that gratitude is heightened when the Lord our God says that to us. Over and over again, in so many ways, the Lord says to us, "The doors to my divine mercy are wide open for you." And that's why on this Gaudete Sunday, we can heed those words of St. Paul in our second reading. "Rejoice in the Lord always. I shall say it again, rejoice." What a powerful image we had this past Tuesday. I hope you all had a chance to see it in Rome, when on the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception, Pope Francis opened the extraordinary Jubilee of Mercy. What a beautiful sight after Mass, when Pope Francis walked and stood in front of those doors in prayer. And then all of a sudden, he pushed them wide open, and he entered through them, followed by Pope Benedict, and cardinals, and bishops, and priests, and religious, and lay faithful. And that very gesture will be repeated in our diocese and throughout the world, throughout this Jubilee year of mercy, when as pilgrims, we will walk through the doors to encounter what? The readings today answer that question: to encounter the Lord, the one who is always near, the one who is our strength and courage, the one who says to us, "Have no anxiety at all, because I never tire of loving and forgiving you." In our diocese, four churches have been designated with the door of mercy. Here at Sacred Heart Cathedral, our Mother of Mercy Church in Little Washington. We also have the door of mercy at Our Lady of Guadalupe in Newton Grove, and in our Basilica, St. Mary in Wilmington. And what will happen? The same thing that happened in Rome. People of all vocations, the young and the aged, the strong and the weak, from every background and culture, will walk through them and encounter the Lord. Why do we do this? Because Mary was conceived without sin. We were not. We're sinners in constant need of God's healing and forgiveness. And so in that spirit, I respectfully encourage all of you before Christmas to celebrate that powerful gift of God's mercy in the sacrament of penance. What a beautiful way to prepare our hearts for the birth of Christ. For in that sacrament, with great humility and trust, we express our contrition, our sorrow for our sins. And then hear those powerful words of absolution, to which Christ himself forgives our sins once and for all, totally and completely. For no sin, no matter how serious, no matter how frequent, is greater than the love of God. And we, who are recipients of mercy, are called also to be instruments of God's mercy. And one of the most powerful ways we can do that is to imitate Christ and his forgiveness. In other words, to forgive one another, especially in this great sacred season of reconciliation. Is it always easy to forgive those who have hurt us, offended us, and maybe even betrayed us? It's not. But God would not ask us to do something we're not capable of doing. And so it's with God's grace that all things are possible. Forgive one another as Christ has forgiven us. And as we seek to be instruments of mercy, we might ask that same question the crowd asked John the Baptist in the gospel. So what should we do? That's what they said. What should we do? And basically, the Baptist answered their question by saying, do the works of mercy. In other words, reach out in compassion and love to those in most need, including the sick and the lonely, the hungry, the thirsty, the homeless, anyone in our midst crying out for help. And how wonderful it is to see those works of mercy being performed daily within this parish and throughout our diocese. You know, sometimes when we walk through life, we close the door to our own God-given potential and possibility because we only see our weaknesses and limitations. Sometimes in life, it seems that others may close the door on us and do not accept and love us as we desire. And sometimes it seems as if the door to serenity and joy is closed in the midst of so much hatred and violence in our world. Yet in the midst of this, we do not despair. We are believers, convinced that the doors of God's mercy are wide open. The precious gift that heals us and forgives us, the gift that allows us to live in harmony with one another, the gift that is far greater than any darkness in this world. So, brothers and sisters, throughout this Jubilee year, together, let's walk through the doors of mercy and encounter the Lord who is near, the Lord who is our strength and courage, the Lord who tells us to have no anxiety at all, for he never tires of loving and forgiving us. No wonder St. Paul says, rejoice in the Lord always. I shall say it again, rejoice.